That is a good rare in our colors, as asked. But this pack has Emissary and Grey Merchant, both of which are better. So we're taking one of those. I don't know which one. Hopefully we table something in this pack. I mean, there's Grey Merchant, Pressing Chimera, Burnished Heart, Erebos Emissary, Cure, and Intrusion, all which we'd play. So I really like our chances to table something here. I guess I'm going to take Erebos' Emissary over Grey Merchant, given that we don't have a lot of black permanents at all. And I really want to be able to play a 4-drop, not another 5. We already have 3 5s. I don't know if that's right, but I'm going to make a pick. And then here, for kind of similar reasons, I'm actually going to take Return Phalanx over Frieza's Cure. I just want permanents and things I can drop in play. Interesting, there's an Ashen Rider, which actually is great in black-white. So if we wanted to be Esper, if we had more defensive white cards, we could look in that direction. But we don't. This is going to go perfectly, actually, in the Fated Retribution deck, if that guy is also black. So if someone to our left took those Wraths and took those Asphyxiates, they actually could have a very good black-white deck with the Ashen Rider. But I'm going to take Return Phalanx. And now, geez, Phalanx Leader and Soldier. So I guess white wasn't cut in pack one. It just wasn't really that deep. But can't be too upset with where we wound up here. I'm going to take one of these. I'm going to take Vaporkin here. We're not that defensive, and we have like a lot of tempo cards. Griptides get a lot better if you have a creature in play attacking them. So actually, Vaporkin's fine in this deck. Man, now there's a favorite Hoplite. So yeah, white actually is quite open. If we'd stuck to our guns, maybe white-blue would have been the place to be. But we'll just take a sip of Hemlock here. And now we'll take a Fortune Hunter. We have Boon. We have Necrobite. Nothing else, but I think this is still better than either of these two in this deck. Could see taking Return to Center here, actually. It blocks pretty well. We just have nothing to do on turn three. Kind of just want to take the Grey Ogre. And here I'm actually going to take Benthic Giant, I think. Oh, no, what am I talking about? Taking Demonic Wall. We have triple Griptide. I was about to be very stupid there for a second. And now, unfortunately, this pack has nothing really for us. I think we're taking Stymied Hopes. I think I'm more likely to play Stymied Hopes than a Thassa's Bounty in this deck. It's close between the two, but I think I'd rather Stymied Hopes. And then hopefully we get something sweet. We don't. We get Traveler's Amulet for our take. Unfortunately, we didn't take the Prophet of Corrupt Fates to splash. Man, this pack had 5 cards we wanted, none of them came back. So there's a Scholar of Athreos and a Frieza's Mender. We have an Amulet. I think I'd be more likely to splash the Scholar in like a slow matchup. And also maybe would want to splash with God's Willing. So I'm just going to take the Scholar here. Ooh, okay, well the Cure and the Wall came back. We already have one Wall. They're a little slow. I'm going to take the Cure here. And then I'll take the Stymied Hopes. So I wish the first Stymied Hopes now was the 6-drop Thassa's Bounty, because I'd rather have 1 and 1. Alright, we'll pick up Return Center. Sure, take this Chosen Mahaliad last. Alright, so looks like our read was wrong on white. It turned out to be really open from the right and cut from the left somehow. But given the signals we were getting, I think we made the right decision with the information we had to kind of eject. Obviously, it would have gone better, I think, if we'd stuck to our guns. It was pretty open back three, but our deck looks fine. It doesn't look insane. It would be awesome if we had those Asphyxiates from pack one. I think we'd have a very, very good deck. But this deck can certainly still win. Being a little ambitious here, cutting these borderline playables. I'm gonna probably have to play all the reasonable stuff and then some. I think I might want one Stymied Hopes here. Maybe it's Eye Gouge. Eye Gouge has random utility. We can cycle it on a Fortune Hunter if we absolutely have to. And then I kind of want one more creature, but I don't think I want the loathsome. The Loathe Father here. I think there's just Diamond Hopes. Make sure they get some people. Oh, there we go. So yeah, the deck turned out, like, not horrific. Not gonna claim that it's good, but I'm gonna say it's not horrific. Yeah, there we go. All right, well, be back for round one.